In the previous video, we saw about models and LoRa. This will be a quick video on style presets. On the top, we saw this dropdown with multiple styles. We also saw how to create a new style. On the right side, this plus icon will create a new style. And this is to duplicate the selected style. This will delete the style. This refresh button will load the styles again from a folder. This will open the folder where the styles will be loaded from. This folder contains styles. You can add or share the styles with others. These styles are individual files. This test one is one of the file. This file. You should see this name inside the brackets. It is the file name and the extension. You can share these files with others. Keep the new file in this folder and click refresh. The drop-down should have the new style. I have a few styles which are commonly used, and you can try it as well. I will share this link in the description below. This folder contains style. So you can download the folder by clicking the download icon in the right. I will save the folder inside utilities, where I kept all the Krita files. Go to the download location and extract the file. With all the styles, you will see this one file is different from others. It is not for styles. It contains the models needed for the style. You have to download those models. Open the style folder. You need to paste the file here. These are the downloaded style. I will copy all the files, excluding the model links, and paste it in the style folder. In Krita, we have the default styles. I will click the refresh button. And I got all the new styles. If I select this, digital style art, the XL in the name means it is using a SDXL model. You can verify by the file name in the brackets. You will see a yellow message. The checkpoint, or I can say the model used by the styles, is not present. The text file contains the checkpoint link. Copy the link and paste it in the browser address. And this is one of the checkpoints for one of the styles we added. Save the checkpoint in Comfy UI folder, Models and then Checkpoint folder. I have given 3 checkpoint to download and 6 style respective to those checkpoint. To use all the style, you need to download this 3 checkpoint. The download is completed. Back to Krita. I tried using one of the styles. Cinematic style XL. I see the checkpoint was found, but the yellow message says XL workload is not installed. There is this exclamation sign at the XL models. If you look at inside workloads, it is checked and installed. I did the installation of workload in the last video. You can restart the Krita software, and this should be fixed. After restart, the message does not appears. The settings are changing based on the style, we can use it now. This style was created at the time of installation, without a checkpoint. You can select any of the checkpoints for the style, or delete it to avoid confusion. I will quickly show you the style and its effect on the image generated. My prompt was a single word, a rat. This was created by using Abstract Art XL. You can see the details if you keep the pointer on the image in the right. I am not an artist or a digital creator to rate this image. But it looks good. The prompt here was a rat, but that is not what the AI model received when I clicked generate. Let's look into configuration. The style selected is abstract art. With the style prompt and negative prompt. The style prompt contains words like abstract expression painting. Then in the bracket, there is a word prompt. The bracket with the word prompt was replaced by this rat. Whatever I type inside the prompt box on the right will be in the same position of this bracket and prompt. The rest, you see, will be appended. And that's the prompt given to the AI model for generating an images. Same goes with the negative prompt, it will be appended. This style prompt you are looking at is from the styles you added just now from the Google Drive I shared. The point here is, you do not have to type the same thing again and again. Below, you see the sampler setting. Sampler affects the image generated by AI models. To understand how it works, I will give you a quick idea from one of my previous videos on diffusion models. The image generation process starts with the image full of noise. The noise is then removed and you get a clear picture as an output. What happens in between is called a denoising process. The denoising process is based on the mathematical formula and logic. After each denoising process, a sample is taken. This sample becomes clear as a final image. There are multiple methods of taking samples, which affect the final image. These are those sampling methods. These are the sampling steps. More steps will give better results. However, after 30 steps, the amount of improvement will decrease. Some turbo models are meant to give results in 5 or 6 steps. You will not be able to get something extra if you make it 30 steps on those models. This guidance scale controls the prompt adherence. Higher the value, more importance will be given to the prompt. Lower value will let the AI be free and creative. Back to the styles, the second is the anime style XL model. I don't know if this style has some specific name, but it reminds me of cartoon movies, where things were realistic, but in a cartoon style. Next is the cinematic style XL model, and this reminds me of Stuart Little style. I should have tried to get a white mouse with some prompt. Next is the comic style XL model. I think this is the best, reminds me of Marvel Comics and a cartoon series named SWAT Cats. Next is digital style art XL. I don't think rat can have such tails by any chance. We can use negative prompts like multiple tail, and this should be fixed. Next is fantasy style XL model. And for some reason, I don't like this image. What are your thoughts? Are any of these styles useful to you? Next is Pixar style. This image needs a Laura. This could have been way better. The last is watercolor style. Painting-like images can be generated. You can also use Laura and merge some other type of painting into it. That is it for this video. In the next video, we will be looking at a real-time painting feature in Krita. Let me know if you have a suggestion for a different topic.